Knapsack is a very interesting problem because in a way, and this is very informal, of course, it is among the easiest NP-complete problems. So whereas click and independent set, for example, seem to be very difficult, Knapsack allows for some pretty interesting algorithms. And one of those algorithms, which will be important for our PTAS, is called a pseudopolynomial algorithm. And you'll soon see why it is named that way. I'm first going to explain the algorithm to you. So you're given an instance of Knapsack, which means you're given n objects. Each one has size s, so we'll just label those sizes here, s1, s2, until you get to sn. Each object also has a value, so the values will be labeled in the same way. So you have v1, v2, and so on, and until you get to vn. And now here's the algorithm to solve Knapsack. The algorithm basically works with a table that looks like this. The table has n rows, 1, 2, 3, down to n. And the table has a lot of columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on and so on and so on, until we get to a number that I'll call v. And by v, I mean the sum of these values here. So the total v1 plus v2 and so on plus vn will be called v. And this is the table that we'll now use. Of course, I still have to tell you what values go into that table. Each cell here in this table is going to have the following meaning. I'll call the row that we're at I, and I'll call the column that we're at j. Then this cell here in row I and column j has the following meaning. The cell here in this table will be the minimum size required to achieve a total value of exactly j using the objects 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on until you get to I. So you cannot use all objects. So for example, in the first row, you can only use object 1. In the second row, you can only use objects 1 and 2. And in the third row, objects 1, 2, and 3, and so on. And that means that sometimes, of course, it's not possible to achieve a value of exactly j using these objects. And so we'll just write a dash into the table if that's not possible. So let's use the example from before. So you had the objects A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And here we have the sizes and the values. So the sizes were 3, 2, 2, 3, and so on. And to construct this table here, we'll of course also have to label those items here. So this is item 1, this is item 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So my first question to you now, brief quiz here, what do we put in here? So how many columns does this table have? And how many rows does this table have?